So this is where the Maple Leafs play, which is kind of a big deal if you're a Toronto kid. As a kid in Canada, hockey is everywhere. And it's so ingrained in our culture and our DNA. Walking to a place like this never gets old, because you look up at these banners. And if you're a hockey fan, my gosh.
Hockey and Adam are a love affair I can never threaten.
This thing's no joke. So this is the original six teams, all the original six barns. And then they've taken two players from each from that era, and they've signed. So we got Johnny Bauer. I think that's Davey Keon.
He and Bret Hart have long text conversations during hockey season, and there's a mood in the house, and it shifts one way or the other depending how the Leafs are doing.
This is another special, like, hockey, but even more than that thing. So this is Maple Leaf Gardens, and this is where Jay and I would go to see wrestling shows. It was the only building with a ramp. My first wrestling match that I ever saw was in this arena. Rene Goulet against Tony Cannonball Parisi.
Right now, we're going to go down to ringside for the Cannonball, Tony Parisi, as he takes on the number one Frenchman, Rene Goulet, in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens.
There's no Maple Leaf Gardens anymore, right? And that's the hockey mecca, that's the wrestling mecca for me. But this is the new generation's version of that. So you come into a place like this, and I look up and I see these banners, and immediately all the stats of when I was a kid, like, so Ace Bailey was hit on the ice by Eddie Shore and never played again, and he was the first player who had his number retired by the Maple Leafs. He's right beside Red Kelly, who's the only player to have his number retired by the Red Wings and the Maple Leafs, which shows he was a big deal. Johnny Bauer is beside him, and Johnny Bauer comes from the era where goalies didn't wear masks. Wendell Clark, that's my era. He was kind of the one shining light for a lot of lean Harold Ballard years, and Leafs fans watching this will understand what I'm talking about.
I was just down there waxing poetic about all the banners, and then walked up here and saw all this stuff. So we're going shopping. If I don't wear that, I'm gonna try and score some jerseys for my little girls, and they will have no choice but to be Toronto Maple Leafs fans this way.
When the game starts, he stands up and sings the Canadian National Anthem in his jammies, and now the girls do that with him.
Okay, so this is for Lyric. She's gonna be the Tavares fan. John Tavares, hometown boy.
Oh my gosh, look at that. We're all closer.
It reminds him so much of Canada, which he loves and misses. So it's a big part of our household.